Today, I'm going to take a look and explore the new AI platform of D5 Render called D5 High, and we will see how we can create these views from this simple screenshot. It is a browser-based application, so you don't need to download anything to use it. If you enter this URL, you can join the waitlist with your email address, and once you have access to it, you can use it for free at the moment. I will use this house as the base model to test it. I want to create an exterior view from this site, so I will simply take a screenshot from the 3D model. Once you launch the D5 High, we have a user interface like this. I think it is pretty friendly and easy to follow. At the top, we can choose different scenarios between architecture and general. Under that, there is a text box where we can describe what we want to create. We can also add a negative prompt with the exclusion button. It works both as text to image and image to image. First, let's try only with text. Here, there are a couple of options for the prompt box. If you click on this one, we find the list of possible keywords we can use in our description for view type, design type, style, architects, if you want to use a similar style, mesh types, materials, and etc. I think it's a pretty useful to have them like this, so I can just click some of them, create something I like. And in addition to these keywords, after I put some description, I can expand my description with this prompt expand option. I believe it uses the existing text with some kind of language model and adds more details that can fit the existing style. And we have three options to choose from. Let's check the advanced tab 2 before generating something to choose the image size. In the advanced tab, we have the settings for the aspect ratio and the image size. The maximum image resolution is 1024 pixel, and it adjusts the other dimension according to the image ratio. I will change the number of outputs to 2 for faster generation and hit generate. The speed of the generation is also related to the number of people using it at the same time, but it was pretty fast, actually faster than I expected. This is the actual speed of the video, so you can see it, but of course it can vary from time to time. And here are the first images. I choose some random keywords for the prompts, so we are not judging the design itself, but the image is pretty nice as a composition and it mostly makes sense. There are no flying elements or weird parts. Then I created a couple more with different aspect ratios. When you click a generation, we have these options under the image, like HD, where you can upscale the existing image, image variation to create similar images to this one, or download if you like the image. Under the text description tab, we have the tab where we can choose additional LoRa models if we want to. When you click it, you can see the ready-to-use models like multi-story, which you can use to add more details on the facades of the buildings, or Zaha Hadid style to have this kind of vibe in your final image. I will try this illustration one to create illustration-like images. After you select a model, you can adjust the effect factor scale from here. I changed my prompt for this one and generated some images, and I really like the images with this additional LoRa model. They all have a super cool vibe and style. Here are some of them. And now I will use the image reference option to create conceptual renders of my project. We have two sections under the image reference, one for the diagram style where you can upload the reference image to create similar style images, and the structure one where I will upload the screenshot I took from the base model. Again, with this slider we can adjust the scale, but if you click on this arrow we can control even more factors. You can choose between sketch, wireframe, and shape options depending on your input. For this one, I chose wireframe and shape ones. Similar to this, we can have more control over the creativity type. If we click on this arrow, then you can change it between creative and accurate. With this slider, we determine how much it will stick with our prompt and how much it will have freedom over the generation. Lastly, I added a simple prompt for our house with copper coverings and describe the surroundings a bit and hit generate. The results are more accurate to the actual design than I expected, to be honest. It's a useful tool for the visualization of conceptual ideas to see more realistic views, but of course it has its own limitations too. Like, we have very little control over the materials in our design. If you want to have a certain type of material on a specific place in the building, it will be pretty challenging to achieve it, or I think it will be real hard to work on a landscape design with specific plants, flowers, and trees. So it is better to combine these different workflows than choosing one site, like either AI or render engine. It will be great to see the idea in the early days of the design with a similar workflow, and later you can work on a more precise model and add the materials you want like this. Same for the landscape design too. I believe D5 is planning to combine this AI feature directly into their render engine, and I am really excited about that. That can be a super cool addition to it. Here are some of the final images I created, both from a 3D model and an interior sketch. I hope you liked the video and the D5 file. The link for the platform is in the video description, so don't forget to give it a try yourself. Thank you, and see you in the next one. And thank you D5 for sponsoring this video.